महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः I was thinking what to speak. You know, when you have a text or something, you know what to speak, it goes on. Would you like to hear an overview of sadhana? Is that okay? Swamiji, whatever you say, please say. Why are you asking us? All right. There is a beautiful line, statement, in the Kenopanishad. Iha ched avedit atha satyamasti na ched iha avedit mahati vinashti. This line means, if one comes to know avedit, if one has known in this life, atha satyamasti, then he has lived a meaningful life. He has lived, then only you can say he has come to have lived. If one has come to know this, atha satyamasti, nachet, in case he has not, mahati vinashtihi, he has wasted his whole. Mahati means immeasurable is the loss. This is what the Upanishad says. So the Upanishads are not asking us how much we have earned. You must be studying Bhajagovindam also, no? Upanishads are not asking how many children you have. No. Only government census will ask you. They are not also asking how much you studied. So Upanishads are asking only one thing. Have you come to know this? Have you come to attain this? So this is a question we all have to ask ourselves. Have we come to realize? Have we come to attain? Those who have attained, please raise your hands. It's a very funny question. Now, when you say attained, reached this truth, it is not that the truth is distant from us, the reality is distant from us by space or time. If something is far away in space, say Kailash, then we'll have to travel there. Because deshataha parichinna, it is limited by space. So that which is limited by space, so you have to take some transport to reach there. There is a temple nearby called Parur. Have you gone? Probably you will be going. That's a place where Adi Shankaracharya's mother used to go and take bath. So we, then we should also go. You can go, but it will take time. You have to take a transport and go. Now this reality is not something which is far away in space. Certain things you don't have to go far away. You'll have to wait for some time. Child is born. You can't get the child married immediately. Child marriage is not allowed. You know, don't say child marriage. You have to wait for some time. You have to wait for the child to... There is no space traveling. There is only time. If something is far away in space, then space plus time has to be covered. Deshataha parichinna, if it is distinct from in space, then you require space, spatial coverage as well as time, what called temporal coverage, we say. Time also. But certain things, you know, you don't have to go by space. Suppose I want to get mustache. I have got mustache now. As a kid, suppose I want to get mustache, I don't have to go anywhere. I have to wait. It takes time. But the reality is not far away from us by space or time. Because the Upanishads declare Tatomasi. So you are that. And therefore, the problem is not I have to wait for some time. The problem is not I have to take a transport and reach. The problem is altogether different. Since the truth is me, myself, the only problem is that there's something blocking my awareness of myself as that reality. There is some kind of defects in me, in my mind, which is preventing this knowledge. Because it is not a question of time, it is not a question of space. That reality, what I am searching for is me, myself, but still I do not come to experience it, I do not come to know it. Therefore, there is a problem, is not, it's a very different problem. There is some correction required in me. There are some obstacles within me which I have to conquer. Right? Is this point understandable? Right? Therefore, this correction, this defect in me which is to be corrected, that is all that is required. So, really speaking, this is a very, very not difficult affair. In the sense, in a sense, like, you know, for example, you got to go to Kailash. You require lots of money. Here, money is not the issue. Suppose you have to climb a mountain. You require physical strength. Here, physical strength is not the issue. Suppose you want to excel in your job. You require certain capacity and efficiency. That is also not required here. And therefore, even though this, what we want to attain, is within us, and therefore it does not require any extraordinary effort, because it doesn't have the requirement of wealth, na karmana, na prajaya, na dhanena. But what has to be done? Tyagena. That some certain defects, certain obstacles in us have to be conquered, certain doshas in us have to be renounced. In Vedanta, we speak of these defects as threefold. One is mala, two is vikshepa, and three is avarana. Very good. Okay. Mala, vikshepa, avarana. All right. So now you already know. I'm very happy that you all know. I congratulate Ved. Right? So three only. Now you see how the topic has come. First we have said that what we want to attain is me, myself. Therefore there is no question of any kind of external effort. All that is required is that certain defects in me are to be overcome. The defects are threefold: mala, vikshepa and avarana. It is like this. Just imagine that there is a beautiful, you know, water body. In that there is a large diamond inside. The three problems involved. Number one, the water may be dirty and therefore I may not be able to see. Or the water could be restless, disturbed, therefore also I may not be able to see. The third thing is that I may not know it is a diamond. So even though I may think it is some glass piece shining, the same way, if you consider the mind to be that water body and that Atman, which is same as Brahman, to be the diamond, then we can speak of three defects. One is mala, next is vikshepa, third is avarana. What is mala? What is mala? Mala, dirt. The word mala means dirt. That is of the nature of samskar. You may also call it as vasana. And as we all know, this samskara or vasana is not something what you can see. An action is something what you can see. A thought is something what you can observe. But samskara is very, very deep, and therefore we say it is ati sukshma. Stula is body, is it not? Sukshma is mind. Samskara is deeper than even the thought. And therefore we say it is ati sukshma. So this ashubha vasana, or what you can say bad samskara, is called as mala, dirt. And since it is ati sukshma, you cannot see it. But then how do we know it? We can come to know it by its expression. What is the expression of this ashubha vasana or dussamskara? The expression is, many expressions can be said, but the ultimate expression or the first expression of it is Vishyasakthi. Vishyasakthi, desire for the Vishaya. So it is desire in one word. Kama. Now we know about the six malas, is it not? The six ripus or the six malas. The six malas are Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madha, Mathsarya. And if you want to summarize all the six in one word, it is Kama. Yeah, all the six is called Shadrupu, six enemies, but that is only giving a different name for all of them, is it not? But if you want to summarize all the six into one, it is called as Kama. I'll just explain how it is. What is Krodha? Krodha is desire not fulfilled, is it not? How much anger you will have? Depends on how much desire you have. Suppose you want something and that want of it is only little and somebody took it away, you say chalta hai, it doesn't matter. But suppose you want it so dearly and somebody has denied that, your anger will be great, is it not? So Krodha is nothing but Kama. So Kama, Krodha, Lobha. What is Lobha? Lobha is nothing but when you fulfill that Kama, you want some more of it. Lobha is greed, is it not? So lobha also is kama. Krodha also is kama. What is moha? Moha is delusion. What is delusion? Delusion is that you see joy there. Delusion is what is not there when you see it is delusion. When the snake is not there, but you see the snake, it is called as moha, delusion. Now, when more and more we feel, one laddu example, or today you all had jackfruit, na? Past 2 days they are giving you jackfruit. I am very happy you are getting it. But you have one, very tasty. Second you have, tasty. Third you have, tasty. And the decision happens, what is the decision? Jackfruit is joyful. Now this is, jackfruit is not joyful. Why jackfruit is not truly joyful? There are people who have jackfruit allergy, you know that? They don't like that smell. Pavam. Now that is moha. So in moha what happens is that you invest the object with a true sense of joy. So moha is also finally kama only. Because with kama being fulfilled leads to lobha as well as moha. And kama not fulfilled leads to krodha. So krodha, lobha, moha and madha. How much jackfruit I have got, you know? I am talking of jackfruit, but other things. Do you know what is my car? Etc. etc. Mother, I am a big man. How did that big man come? Because of karma being fulfilled. And mathsarya is what? Somebody has extra than you. The object what you like, karma. And therefore, when you say mala, it looks as kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, based from a, which is vishayasakti in fact, and coming from a samskara. But ultimately you can reduce the whole thing as kama. Right? And that is why Bhagavan Shri Krishna says, kama yesha, krodha yesha, rajoguna samudbhavaha, mahashana, mahapapma. That papma is what? Mala. Right? Mala. How do we remove mala? We are talking of sadhana. Huh? How do we remove mala? Opposite of kama you have to do. You have to be. Always the antidote will be opposite of the problem. If kama is the problem, what is the antidote of it? Nishkama. And what is nishkama karma called as? Nishkama karma called as? Karma yoga. What is karma yoga? Karma yoga is to say, I don't want anything. I am doing only for the happiness of God. Always we do things for our happiness, for our karma. Now we say, I am not doing anything for my karma. I am doing it for God, Ishvara. So karma overpowered by, overcome by nishkama. And when we do that, what happens? Karma has no chance to come. Oh, Swamiji, but how to have jackfruit with nishkama bhava? All that you have to tell is that this body belongs to God, not mine. And then what happens? You don't eat jackfruit for your happiness, you eat jackfruit for God's happiness. And therefore you will be careful because it's God's body. And if you flood your stomach with jackfruit, God's body will suffer. See how small things also. It is not that karma yoga means you have to go and work for the nation, then only it is karma yoga. No, even scratching the head can be done in karma yoga bhava. Yes, this head belongs to God and there is a problem in the head, therefore let me scratch. Okay, So kama can become nishkama. Then kama will not find expression. When kama doesn't have expression, krodha will be there? No. When krodha is not there, kama, krodha, kama is not there, therefore lobha also no, madha also no, mathsarya also no. So now by one nishkama karma called karma yoga, what has happened? All the papas have been negated. And this again and again, again and again we do. What happens? All the papa goes away. Because they are not getting food. Kama grows because we feed it. Is it not? Like how ghee, how does a fire go? By adding more and more ghee. The same way, kama grows by feeding it. When you don't feed kama, kama dies in time. Kama is not overpowered by feeding it. Kama is really speaking, not overpowered by not feeding it also. But kama is overpowered by understanding that without kama, I can be happy. And that karma yoga shows you. Yes, without kama, I can be happy. That kama eats all papa. Which papa? All this kama, krodha, lobha. Kama eats, nishkama eats away all papa, like kama, krodha, lobha, moha. There's one nice verse in Bhagavad Gita. Brahmanyadhaya karmani. Brahmanyadhaya karmani? Ishvara. Brahmana? Having offered the action unto God. Sangham tyaktva karotiha. For my happiness I want to do. This is Sangha. Sangham tyaktva karotiha. Lipyate nasa papena. He is not touched by papa. He is not touched by papa means what? Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, mathsarya. Some people say he is not touched by papa means if he does papa also he won't be touched. No, 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 no. It is wrong meaning. Lipyate nasa papena. And how is he in life? Padma patra mivambasa. Even though those papa could be there, na, lucky sukshma form, na? It's there. But Padma Patra, like the lotus leaf in water, he remains untouched. And slowly all those papas also vanish. Okay? So Mala is overcome by Nishkama Karma or Karma Yoga. So first defect, this way. Now second defect, Vikshepa. If mala is ashubha samskara or ashubha vasana, vikshepa means restlessness. In English, in Sanskrit, if you want to say, chitta chanchalyam. Chanchala? Chitta chanchalyam. The restlessness of the mind. Meaning a person is not able to focus, is not able to give attention, is not concentrating. Really speaking, nobody can say we don't have attention or concentration. Lack of attention. We have concentration, we have the capacity to focus in what? In what we like. So when we watching a movie, one time watches a movie, you know, all the songs are by heart. How can you say that the child doesn't have concentration? In the exams he may be scoring poor. That is because he may not like the subject. So when we say lack of concentration is vikshepa, it has to be understood in the right context. What is that? Vedanta shravane, swatmanu sandhane, chitta chanchalyam. Vedanta Shravana. In Vedanta, when I hear to Vedanta, my mind goes away. Otherwise, my mind is ready. Or when I'm meditating, only my mind is going. Samji, what is the use of meditating, Samji? If I meditate, I cannot meditate. My mind is going everywhere. Many people give up meditation because they think in meditation they get more disturbed. So this is an expression of vikshepa. So what is Vikshepa? Inattention, lack of focus or concentration in Vedanta. The means of self-realization. Okay? Now how is this overcome? If weakness of the mind causes this, suppose we have weakness of the body, what do? We go to gym and make our body strong, is it not? Now, suppose the mind is weak, what should we do? We should again go to a gym. And that gym is called as upasana. What is upasana? Upasana is what? Upasana is, you know, in Gurudev's life history, you know, you must have seen that when he was a small boy and he got bored with all the big pujas, what he used to do, he used to close his eyes and then visualize that Lord in his mind. Now this is upasana. Now the mind is getting distracted. Now to the mind which is getting distracted, you are giving an exercise. What is the exercise? Now this Bhagavan Shri Krishna is there in front of me. This Adi Shankaracharya is in front of me. Let me see his face. Now you close your eyes and you see his face. And slowly you start seeing his whole body. Now when you can capture that again and again when you do this exercise, the mind naturally becomes focused, concentrated, gets the ability to focus. And therefore, we say, Vikshepa is conquered. The defect of Vikshepa is conquered by Upasana. The restless mind, you are giving it an exercise to become focused in one place. You are giving an exercise for it to totally absorb what it is seeing. And again we practice it. The word upasana comes from the word upa plus asanam. That object is seated outside, is it not? That object, you are bringing it inside, upa, near you. So making an object come to you is called upasana. Usually the object does not come because the mind is so restless. Now what you do is that you make the object come within you and you retain the object, make the object sit closely into you, upasana. All right. Now, let me tell you something which is both a remedy. Now, Karma Yoga is a remedy for what? Mala. Upasana is a remedy for what? Vikshepa. Now let me tell you one remedy which can conquer both. Any guesses? Any guess? Japa. Japa has got the power to conquer both. How? In Japa, we bring Bhagavan inside. And when you bring Bhagavan inside, Bhagavan is Sarva Kalyana Guna Murti, is it not? The very thinking of Bhagavan purifies the mind. Okay, Mala is conquered. Now what are you doing in Japa also? In Japa, you are also fixing the mind on the form, on the name of the Lord, is it not? So again, fixing the mind also happens. Are you getting it? Mala, impurity of the mind is conquered. How is the impurity of the mind conquered? By bringing the form of the Lord or the name of the Lord and enjoying that Japa itself, what happens? The Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, because you are giving it a different object to enjoy and the mind is getting greater joy, then what will happen? Seeing the greater joy, the lower joy goes away. Kama goes away. When Kama goes away, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madha, mathsarya, everything goes away. So Japa has given you mental purity. And japa, when you are doing with focus. You are repeating the same name without a break, keeping your attention on that. And then what is happening? You are giving it an exercise of focus. Therefore, chitta sthairyam is also happening. And therefore, we say japa is the most potent sadhana. Namasmaranadanyopayam nahi pashyamo bhavatarane Ram Hare Krishna Hare Tava Nama Vadami Sada Nrhare. Namasmaranat Japa Anyopayam. We don't see a better method. Nahi Pashyamo Bhavatarane. What is Bhava? Bhava is Samsara. For conquering Mala and Vikshepa, we don't find a better means. Adi Shankaracharya. Okay? So, Mala, Vikshepa. Achha, there are some people. Swamiji, this Bhagavan, now you are telling surrender action to Bhagavan. So, Bhagavan koon hai? Pata nahi, koon hai, what? And this Namasmarana you are telling, then all those things, you know, are not touching me. There are people, huh? We should not think that, you know, Bhagavan is not inspiring for many. Any idea? Options given. Shastra. Do you love your guru? Of course, Swamiji, my guru. Bhagavan to I do not know. But guru is my Bhagavan. Ah. Totakacharya. Is it not? How you all must have seen Upanishad Ganga? Last episode, only for him guru was God. He had no God, guru was God. Manasa, vacha, karmana, pushkalena, dhanena, whatever wealth, anything, all is for my guru. Total surrender unto the guru. This also does the job of purification. This also guru pasana. Ishwara, Guru. Some people are not even attached to Guru. Every category is there. Shastra, study. Oh, I love it. Upanishad, I can study. No harm. Even that also is a means. But it has to be continuous. Non-stop. We have to focus on this. Anena aditena ahoratran sandadhami. Anena aditena, what I have studied, ahoratran, day and night I am connecting and making it as one. Asuptehe, ahamrtehe, nayed, kalam vedanta chintaya. Till I go to sleep, till I die. Now this is again another method. It's also continuously studying Vedanta and remembering the truths of Vedanta also purifies the heart. Nahi jnanena sadrisham pavitra miha vidyate. It is the aparoksha jnana, of course, but even this jnana has the power to purify. So either catch Ishvara or catch Guru or catch the Shastra for removing Mala and Vikshepa. All right. This karma yoga, this upasana is called as Bahiranga Sadhana. Bahiranga Sadhana, anga limb, or limb you can say, bahi external limb. This is preparatory sadhana. You can say Bahiranga preparatory. Okay? So, doing karma yoga and upasana, the dirt of the mind is cleansed and the mind has got the capacity to focus. So how is this person's mind? What the Vedanta Shravana, the person is able to do with focus. So focus is there. And then the mind is pure. The mind is pure means what? No Vishyasakthi. And when the mind has no Vishyasakthi, Brahmasakthi can come. Atmasakthi can come. Only then it can come actually. Empty thyself, for I shall fill thee. Such a person goes to the next sadhana, which is called as Antharanga Sadhana. So let us put in mathematical form. Bahiranga Sadhana is equal to Karma Yoga plus Upasana plus one sadhana conquering both, Japa. All right. Now we come to Antharanga Sadhana. Now that the mind is pure and the intellect is quietened, intellect is focused, now is a time when knowledge can be given. Why knowledge? Because what we want to know is we ourselves. If what I want is Kailas, to go to Kailas, then knowledge plus action is required. Because I need to know where Kailas is and I need to take an action to reach there. But here, what I want to know, the Upanishad is teaching myself to be Brahman. Such a thing, the Atman which I want to know is not far away. Therefore, action is not there. Since it is me myself, I have to know myself to be Brahman, that's all. And therefore, what is required is only knowledge. When it comes to knowledge, there are three problems again. Why three problems? Again I said, there are three problems. Problem one, let me give you an example. Titikaka. What? Titikaka. What? It's some kind of tea or coffee? What is it? I don't know what it is. That's the first problem. I don't know. I have no idea. A bhavana. No idea. First problem. Somebody tells you, I don't understand. That was the problem of my mathematics teacher. He taught me. I didn't understand. Asambhavana. Not comprehending. Second problem. And third is that I don't experience it. Titikaka is a, anybody knows Titikaka? It's a lake. Very good. Where is it? Okay, unnecessarily why trouble you. It is a lake found in South America on top of the Andes. Now don't ask me what is Andes. Andes is a mountain range in South America. It is the world's tallest freshwater lake. School teacher, she will know. I also study in school only. Right? I don't know. Now it is gone. Okay? Now I don't understand. Andes? What is Andes? Fresh water? What is fresh water? Salt water, fresh water? Oh, okay. Lake? Lake means how much big? I don't understand. And third thing, I know, I understand. I have to see, experience it. There are three problems. I don't know is solved when the teacher explains. The teacher may explain, but I must listen, no? Therefore, listening solves the first problem of I don't know, and listening is called Shravana. too much data, right? Doesn't matter. Overview of sadhana is a topic, so I have to cover. So listening solves the problem of abhavana. I don't know. What is it? I don't know. What is the message of the Upanishads? I don't know. Or what is the essence of the teaching? I do not know. And what is the essence of the teaching? You are that supreme reality. So this is called as the jiva, I, is one aikya with Brahman. So jiva brahma aikya is the message of the Upanishadic teaching. This I should get to know. Sometimes we listen to a talk, we listen to a lecture, we get to, you know, hear many, many things, and we get lost in the details and fail to comprehend the essence. Many people, you know, when we used to go for Gurudev's lectures and all, no? Used to listen to all the lectures, and Gurudev used to crack so many jokes and all stories, he used to tell anecdotes, he used to love and enjoy. And then when we used to go back, and somebody, you know, in the school, they asked, what did you, where did you go? You were not, we went to Gurudev's lecture. What did you understand? What did you learn? Then we tell one joke. Now, that is not listening, Shravana. Shravana is to get the essence. The joke, the story is meant for a point. Did you guess the point? So Shravanam Nama, what is Shravana? Shravana is Tatparya Avadharanam. Is grasping the essence. Alright, I have grasped the essence, but I don't understand how, what? I am Brahman? What Brahman? I am Brahmana, not Brahman. How I am Brahman? My body is going to, you know, I am going to die one day, I am an old man now. Brahman is Nitya. Then we understand, you know, you are not the body. Because what you see, you are not. You are the seer, not the seen. You are the pure consciousness. That consciousness is always the same. It is Nitya. Therefore, this consciousness is Brahman. Oh, alright, alright, alright. Oh. Now, this is logic. Drishya Viveka. Seer and the seen. Is it not? So applying logic and comprehending, and this logic also is given in the scripture. And therefore, Shruti Anusarini Yukti. The logic which follows the scripture, which helps you to understand. Mathematical theorem is there, and the proof of the theorem also is given. So this way, to understand for oneself what the teacher says is true, what the Shastra says is true, is Manana. If Shravana ends in understanding what the essence of the scripture, Manana ends when you say, yes, what I hear is right. You have to put your signature, yes, it is correct. So Shravana removes Abhavana, I don't know what it is. Manana removes Asambhavana. Asambhavana, the feeling, I do not think it is right. I don't comprehend. Both these meanings are there in Asambhavana. And then I say, it is right. That strong determination should come from our own heart saying, yes, I am Brahman. Manana. Right? And the third one, first point is what? I don't know what it is. Second point, I don't understand. And third is what? I don't experience. Okay, I have understood I am Brahman. Do I feel I am Brahman? I feel I am Brahman in the class. When I go outside and I see my slipper is not there, then I become what I was before. Is it not? So, Nididhyasana. In Nididhyasana, what happens is that the thought I am so and so, which is so deep rooted in me, is broken by opposite thought, I am Brahman. That is what it does. The thought, see, we have understood that we are Brahman, but our life is what? I am so and so only. I am man, I am woman, I am this person, I am that person. I am mother, I am father. These are more stronger than I am Brahman. You know, when we are given our names, no? When we became sannyasi, our Guruji gave us names. And even if they call us, we won't turn back. Why? Because it has not gone into me. Normally, when we are sleeping, when somebody calls our name, we get up. After getting sannyasa, even if they call our name, we won't get up. Why? It has not gone into. There was one great saint by name Appaya Dhikthishar. Great saint. He wrote commentaries on Brahma Sutra, one great text called Siddhantalesha Sangraha and all. Great teacher also he was. So once he decided to find out what is there in his deep mind. So he called his Shishya and said, I am going to take this medicine, some Ayurvedic concoction, some medicine. And when I take that, whatever is there in my mind will come out. You please write it down. I will keep blabbering. You write it down. I don't think anybody will take that chance. We don't want to tell what is there in our mind. Is that okay? For some time, you know, you go into some kind, whatever comes out. Then after he came back to normal, you know, normalcy, he said, bring it. And they brought. And what was written? Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi. Nothing other than Aham Brahmasmi. Why? It has gone within. Yata dehoham, jivoham, purushoham, brahmanoham, shudroham, iti trida nishchayaha. You understand this? Tata naham brahmanaha, na shudraha, na purushaha, kintu asangaha, sachidananda swarupaha, sarvantaryami, chidakasha rupaha. Aham iti drida nishchayaha. Aparoksha jnanavan sajivan muktaha. This is clear? Just as how I am a man is so strong now, just as how I am so and so is strong now, in the same way, if I have the strong feeling, I am the Supreme Brahman, I am the pure consciousness, then that is called realization. Nididhyasana brings this. By attacking a thought, strongly by the opposite thought. What you understood, you make it deep within you so that wrong thought is rooted out fully. Atmavare drashtavyaha. Brahadaranyaka Upanishad. Experience a self. How? Shrotavyo, mantavyo, nididhyasitavyaha. Shravana, manana, nididhyasana. And since these are closer to realization, they are called as antaranga sadhana. In Brahadaranyaka Upanishad, Shankaracharya, while commenting on this line, he says something very interesting. He says, yada yetani ekatam upayanti. Yada yetani, yetani shravanam manana nididhyasana, ekatam upayanti, they become one. What do you mean shravanam manana nididhyasana become one? When I hear aham brahmasmi shravana, I understand I am Aham Brahmasmi and I live that knowledge Aham Brahmasmi. Tada then alone samyak darshanam, this real vision, brahmatmaikatva lakshanam of the nature of realization of the oneness of self and brahman prasidati, then alone it has happened, not otherwise. So initially first Shravana, then Manana, then Nididhyasana. But what should be the final one? Shravana at the same time, Manana at the same time, Nididhyasana. Then it is finalized. All right. This is Antharanga Sadhana. So what is the lakshya? Lakshya is myself realizing it to be Brahman. It is not far away. Therefore, karma is not required. What is required? Jnana alone is sufficient. Because it is me, myself, I am not knowing. I don't have to do anything. It is me, myself, I have not understood. Therefore, jnana alone is required. Jnana devatu kaivalyam. But jnana immediately will not work. Why? Because the mind is so dirty. The mind is so fickle. Therefore, the mind has to be first corrected. And the mind, and the, what are the problems? Mala, Vikshepa with the mind first. So Mala is overcome by Karma Yoga. Why? Because Kama is, Kama's antidote is Nishkama. Vikshepa, which is restlessness, its antidote is the practice of single-pointedness, Upasana. Or if you want to conquer both of them, Japa, Namasmarana. Conquer both of them, mind becomes perfect. And to this perfected mind, knowledge can be fed. And how does can knowledge be fed? First, understand what the scriptures are trying to tell through the Guru, Shravana. First, understand what they are trying to tell. Then, comprehend it to be true by removing your doubts by Manana. Shravana, Manana. Then afterwards, conquer the deep seated vasana by opposite. Thoughts only make vasana. The vasana of Aham Jiva has come because of many, many janmas. We have repeated the thought. Now conquer that by a right thought. And what is that? Nididhyasana. You see the word Nididhyasana? Ni for Nishchaya. Dhyasana means repeating, repeatedly meditating. Repeatedly meditating what? What we have done Nishchaya by Manana. First Shravana, then Nishchaya happened by Manana, and then you can meditate. Otherwise what happens? We may say, Chidanandarupaha Shivoham, Shivoham, Chidanandarupaha Shivoham, Shivoham. At that time a question will come. How? Gone your meditation. Why? Nishchaya has not happened. When you put the knife on the butter, what kind of butter? Not butter from the fridge. Okay. Butter. And when you put the knife, what happens to the, it just goes without any kind of difficulty. In the same way, Nididhyasana should go without difficulty. And that will happen when Nishchaya is there and when Mala and Vikshepa have been already conquered. Alright. So Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. So Antaranga Sadhana plus Bahiranga Sadhana plus Antaranga Sadhana is equal to Sadhana. So lot of mathematical formulas we have seen. All right. That is. I know it's a heavy session, but I think it is okay because I can see from your faces that you are able to manage. Very, very happy that all of you have come here. Tomorrow is the last day, is it not? I saw your photograph also, group photo. Nice photograph. All of you smiling, radiant faces. And I'm also very, very happy that Brahmachari Veds, first camp begins from the birth home of Adi Shankaracharya. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ever bless him. Of course, all of you too. Remember, iha ched avedit atha satyamasti na ched iha avedit mahati vinashti. Upanishads are warning. In fact, not warning, in fact, encouraging us. If you come to know this truth in this life, your life is purposeful. If you don't, not sure when you will get human life, and that too guru, very, very rare. So let's put all our efforts to go by these sadhanas and reach the ultimate. May Pujya Gurudev, may Bhagavan Shankaracharya's bliss be always with us. It is possible. It is not difficult. Only thing, we have to put our efforts in that. Thank you all very much. Hari Om.